dog.
Yeah. And the dog too. How's it going? Oh, you saw it?
This is what happens when you call the cops. Say what? This is what happens when you call the cops. Come on. This is what happens when you call the cops. You get your rights violated or you all get shot. This is what happens when you call the cops. This is what happens when you call the cops. This is what happens when you call the cops. You get your rights violated or you all get shot.
I'm sick of people being victimized by criminal cops. Psychopathic predators terrorizing neighborhood blocks. Equipped with pepper spray, mace, cuffs, tasers, and glocks. They like serial killers acting out subliminal thoughts. Forget what you taught. These cops have got a license to kill. Witness intimidation means that they can use it at will. Code of silence means that the pigs will never let out a squeal. And if they go to court, they know the judge will make them a deal. For real, that's why they stopping me, locking me up and stopping me. Confiscating my property, talking in my demography. Making the poor commodities, profiting off of poverty. Enforcing policies, supporting prison economies, yeah. No one makes money when the violence stops. Hating brutality is the way to make a criminal crop. Blood in the gutters, how the rich butter they bread at the top. And that's why this is what happens when you call the cops. Come on.
This is what happens when you call the cops. This is what happens when you call the cops. This is what happens when you call the cops. You get your rights violated or you all get shot. This is what happens when you call the cops. This is what happens when you call the cops. This is what happens when you call the cops. You get your rights violated or you all get shot.
911, what's your emergency?
I'm fixing the system and these pigs is trying to murder me. They made me, they dazed me, they trained them to hate me. Degrade and detain me and change just like slavery. Hands up, face down, left hook right quick. Throw you down, hold you down, smack you with that nightstick. Night shift, riding around, see you with your J's on. You'll get sprayed on over Skittles, word to Trayvon. All the people saying is it's crazy down in Florida. What you saying is you playing, it's the same in California. They ganging like they banging and they'll hang you down in Georgia. Frame you in a case for what you say without a lawyer. Swarming with no warning, now they sorting through your residence. Storming with no warning, now they snorting all the evidence. You better just learn to dodge a box, cause this is what happens when you call the cops.
Come on! This is what happens when you call the cops. Say what? This is what happens when you call the cops. This is what happens when you call the cops. You get your rights violated or you all get shot. This is what happens when you call the cops. Come on! This is what happens when you call the cops. Say what? This is what happens when you call the cops. You get your rights violated or you all get shot.
We got a baby in the living room.
Get the grenades, pull a pin, throw it in the crib, blow him away.
There's a homeless guy camping here.
Well, tell him to pack. When he gets up and starts leaving, shoot the bum in the back.
This guy rolled through a stop sign.
That's drugs for sale. Get some doctors to rape him, send him a bill in the mail.
We got a black man knocking on a white woman's door.
With 10 shots,
oh,
point
is that
blank,
your mom
he ain't gonna
right
knock
there?
No more.
I don't
like
that thing.
Yeah. I'm 81. Need some light?
Might
as well too, huh?
No, I get pulling out the screws and just noticing how many nuts
are.
But I collect screws and
oh yeah.
Marbles, drill bits.
Yeah, I do all the time, man.
Yeah. It's just a little. Oh hey, what's this? Is that foreskin grabber? Pretty sure.
Eyelash curler.
Screws, come on now. Pretty sure it's for the nut sack.
Hurts yeah. So good, I guess.
Oh, fuck, I bet.
Right on, how you hanging?
Oh, fucking hanging, I'm dragging.
Yeah, I hear you.
I just came back from Whale Wall, which is kind of interesting.
Oh, yeah?
Yeah, I haven't been down there for. Never been down there.
It seems pretty transient to me.
Is it?
Young and transient. More youthful, and then maybe not more trans. There were some people who are pretty solid there, but I mean, as far as being there a long time, but
yeah.
It also seems to take a pass-through place for some people when they first come in town or something like that, maybe, or young kids.
Yeah, fair enough.
But
It was pretty cool. I was down there with a friend, and she's pretty youthful. She's like 21 or
yeah.
22, I don't know, something like that. And she won't come up to the block because she just beat up here a couple times.
Yeah, you get a lot of that. The young kids, they just either they just want to avoid it or they just want to six up. They just want to
FTP. Yeah.
Yeah, the cops that flag of mine, which turned out pretty funny yesterday.
Did they like it?
Well, no, they didn't like it, but I didn't care.
Do they know what it means? I guess so.
Oh yeah, but like I was sitting there, and some guy come pulling in, and I was actually just filming it because I wanted to get a short clip to put on Twitter to show the flag flying button with the cop car right there. Police station, and some guy comes pulling into the police station, and he says, not the best place to have in that there, and I said, what's that? Because I wanted to make sure he said it louder for me.
Yeah.
He said it right into my cameras, and he says, not a good place to be here with a fuck the police flag. So I'm just going to take that and cut the clip down to him saying fuck the police. It's a cop, eh?
Yeah.
And then they were all nervous about it. People kept sort of going by and cars coming by to check me out. Anytime I photographed outside the police station, it always happens. Here comes the cops again. And so they sent out two older cops, and I knew both of them. They knew both me for years, like old courthouse, Tent City stuff, whatever.
Yeah.
That. So they came by. By and they were talking to me, and they're like, oh yeah, as if they were just walking by, but they didn't mention the flag. It was like, it's attached to my trailer flying there, and they don't even say nothing. They're just like, oh yeah, 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 as if it's not there. It's like, yeah. It's so pretty funny.
Yeah.
But they're nice cops. So they're, I've never seen them be pigs, you know, whatever those two guys that were talking to me, so I had no grief with them.
Yeah.
There's two of them now, and it looks like they got a plan meeting. Yeah. Although they're just stopping some guy in front of a hotel down there. Closer to City Hall on the left.
Yeah.
They handcuffed him and hauled him away.
What are they going to turn back in here just to be goofed?
I don't know. It almost seems synchronized the way that the one came out of the parking lot behind the other one. Are they going by or are they driving in?
I just watched the fucking headlights on the curb.
Yeah, oh yeah, because I can't see anything myself, yeah.
I think went by because they're still going slow.
And then the best thing happened. I was going home after that, and I stopped at this hill. I've been doing drumming when they're like that, and so I stopped at the hill across where the bridge used to get off. Played drums a while, then I came back to downtown, and I was getting ready to leave, and I'm parked, and I'm going down, should we just take a shortcut home, talking to my dog, and all of a sudden I look to the right, and here comes the Cops for Cancer. They're out on a training run. They're all in their kit, the yellow stuff, Cops for Cancer on the side of them. I'm like, fuck this. I pulled out in front of them. And then we were riding along the goose for a while, and they were right behind me. And I was watching my mirror to make sure that they were going to try to overtake me. I sped up so they couldn't overtake me. So it looked like I was leading the Cops for Cancer with the fuck the police flag. Everyone on the trail's going by and looking at them, and they see my flag going by. And they're like, that was hilarious. Hey.
That's righteous, man.
And then I let them, and then I ended up, I knew that they were going to be slow going up the hill over passing the highway.
Yeah.
So I followed them the whole way, all the way from fucking downtown through to by the mall. And then I passed them going up over the bridge.
Motherfucker! fucking villain. The definition is clear, you're the witness of a killing. This nigga in place without a clue. And once you're on the scope, your ass is through. Look, you might take it as a trip, but a nigga like Ren is on the gangster tip, straight out of Compton.
And they followed me the rest of the way until my place. I turned off right before City Hall, and they train out of the City Hall there, the cop shop. And then when I pulled off like this, I stopped right there, and my back camera was caught them riding by. So I'm gonna make a funny video out of it. Plus, I also filmed down there, and I caught the cops with cancer and training runs going through the stop sign without obeying the law. They were like that whole pattern just not obeying the law. So.
Hi, it's the police.
Unfortunately, you didn't stop over the stop sign, which is required.
Just reminding cyclists today, if you're going to be on the road, we got to make sure we're playing by the rules of the road.
Right turn, pull center, hold center. Bikes up,
bikes up, bikes up, hold center,
hold center.
Bike up,
bike up.
Yeah, bike up.
We're just reminding cyclists today that you have to follow the rules of the road.
God, we are witnessing a fucking bank robbery.
Holy fuck.
Holy fuck. Oh my fucking God.
The part that wasn't predictable and that wasn't safe is that you weren't stopping.
Hi there. Hi, it's the police. Can I get you to stop, please? Hey, how are you?
Yeah, do you understand why I'm stopping you?
Oh, a couple of things.
So if you don't leave now, I'm going to place you under arrest.
You know how to put in an official police complaint?
Oh, yeah, I'm doing that for sure. Yeah, yeah.
So you know how to do that?
That's the best way you feel to spend our province's resources.
You know what? We don't need to carry the car. You don't need to become belligerent.
No, we're good, bud. I will arrest you.
There is a concern. We've got two people set up in front of our police station with camera cameras. Is this ID? I can identify you.
This is an investigation, so...
Sure, yeah.
This is police department.
I'm not going to give any... I'm not going to ID myself or nothing like that at all.
So please, can I have a quick word with you? So we're down here doing some education, reminding people we got to play by the rules of the road. So it's really important that you stop for the stop sign, that you're using the bike lanes and stuff.
We cannot expect people to have respect for law and order until we teach respect to those we have entrusted to enforce those laws.
Hey, you'll make a funny video.
Can I give you my email? Because some of these things you edit and do this and
yeah.
that. You know what I mean? Fuck police. You know, get VicPD saying that and fucking shit. Fuck that. Anyway, black and white, that's fucking dope.
Hell yeah.
Their colors, you know?
Yeah, totally.
That's awesome.
But for sure, I got it written down on here.
You got an extra doobie?
Actually, I'm just going to grab it here, but I'm going to give you this first of all. And where is it? Right here, I think.
Here's my gardener.
Right on, man. Good man.
The gardener. Pardon moi.
Does he pay well?
Huh?
Does he pay well?
Pays in affirmations. No, you're doing great.
Yeah, I put smoke up his ass.
God damn it, some butterfingers here tonight.
Yeah, we're gonna wrap it off.
So, yeah, my email's on there. Yeah, my phone's up.
Yeah, bro.
I'll get a J out here for you.
Fuck the police!
Do you get any, like, warm sweaters?
I was getting
this guy, I know he's got to be stringy or something. I got a trench coat and a hoodie off. My silver trench coat.
Anything with skulls and flames? Nothing in blue and nothing with stripes.
Nothing I think one's blue and one is a stripe.
Thank you, my brother.
That's awesome. Okay, I'll see what you got. Hey, do you want any straw?
Okay.
I got a hay bale that I had to like get out of somewhere and then I was gonna take away, but then I was like, if you guys want straw, you put the straw down, then you put your tarp on, wicks the moisture away when the ground gets
wet.
Yeah, for sure.
If you want to, I've got like a whole bale.
Yeah, I love it.
7-0.
Are they stopping here?
Same
oh,
what's
that? Are they stopping here?
Me?
No, are they stopping
here? Yeah, right, just stopping right behind.
I wonder if it has anything to do with this Harley.
She's drinking a drink, so she doesn't look too serious.
What?
She's drinking a drink, so she doesn't look like she's ready for action. So. Straw drinking out of her coffee. So.
Still sitting there?
Yeah. But I think she's got something to do. I think so. It's just intimidation. They just don't look like they're getting ready to do anything.
Yeah, no, if you're running from everybody's plate, it's like he's all thinking. Active.
Oh, yeah?
I moved my mom's minivan.
Now she's rolling down.
I moved my mom's minivan onto Kansas City behind Cordoff. Onto their lawn. And then I put a black tarp over top of her van. Maybe there were six pigs there at her van, eh? Like minutes after that. And I was at the top of Kansas City at her kitchen.
Yeah.
And I see this, see them all converging on my mom's van. I'm like, yo, get the fuck out of there, man.
Here they come again.
Yeah. I come up here and they're gonna check cruise bike, he's insured. They have a problem with that. And I'll get my girl to ride it out of here for me. Greece are not being psyched.
Yeah. Like, what do they think that they're here protecting us?
Yeah. Bro, get the fuck out of sight. Like, fucking walk. Bruce got glasses, leather jacket, you can tell he's a biker there. It's all good.
Yeah,
but... See, bikes after me, it's all good.
So they know me, they know my camera's rolling now, so...
Cool.
This guy's the sweater then.
Want these?
Hey, sweater guy.
Sweater guy?
I'm Slap the Goose guy.
Slap the Goose guy?
Did I get Bruce?
Totally.
I've never addressed myself that way. What I gotta do is stop coming down here and asking people how they're feeling.
on your knee. Which punched me in the face.
Above ground?
Yeah, yo, that's about it, man.
Oh, not bad. That's pretty weak.
How about I sit
from the...
Why don't I slap it?
Off the back. Bruce, you want a cigarette?
No, I'm good, thank you. Same boat. I got two physical disabilities, and I got a busted neck, and I also got I'm on my third cancer now. These last two were supposed to have been terminal, but I sort of beat the other ones, confused on what's going on. But anyways, yeah, I'm in the same boat. Tons of specialists and doctors. I do have a good family doctor too. But like when you talk about dogs, yeah, I'm gonna talk to my buddy back in like the DC housing complex I live in, because he should get one, because he has enough seizures and he keeps getting injured and stuff like that.
Yeah, and he just needs a lifeline button.
Yeah.
They're like $40 a month.
Yeah.
Okay. And the dog will fucking save his ass.
Yeah. Oh, fuck yeah.
And like, he doesn't even have bad seizures. He just has a bunch of seizures.
Yeah, his aren't seizures so bad. Well, I don't know, but they're bad enough that he usually gets severe injuries. Yeah. He'll fall and just face plant and smash his face in.
The dog will tell when he's going to have a seizure and like get him to sit down and shit.
Yeah.
Cool.
That's right, I heard about that too.
They're
That's
trippy,
neat.
Man. They're fucking smart.
Oh, yeah, man. I love dogs.
They're like, sit, go down, they'll stay down until you come and get up.
Yeah.
You put their food up, turn the leader, time for them to eat and stuff. Like,
I love that idea, man. I'm going to take that to my buddy, man. It's a good idea.
$30,000 dog.
Yeah, well, but I'm a good advocate for him, because I'm an activist. I do. I help people get shit all the time. So I brought down the Victorian chief of police once.
Preventing me from doing my job, so I will arrest you.
You're stoned.
You
got one more time.
I will arrest you.
Yeah. Stop talking.
We're just over here to have a conversation with you.
With complaints against police, and there is no shortage of them. The Victoria Police Department says investigating complaints about its members is putting a heavy burden on the department. VicPD says, in fact, it has more officers investigating police complaints than it does looking into child pornography, child abuse, or financial crime. Victoria's Chief of Police Jamie Graham has been given a written reprimand for failing to properly store a loaded pistol. It is the latest in what has been an embarrassing week for the chief and for VicPD.
A comment made by Victoria's Chief of Police about Olympic torch protesters has come back to burn him.
They held him over on a bus, and there was a cop driving the bus. So, you know, I don't know who these guys are, but they're not terribly well organized.
An investigation done for the Police Complaints Commission has found that Chief Jamie Graham committed discreditable conduct.
I've proposed the disciplinary action of a written review.
In 2008, the Police Complaints Commission found Chief Graham had engaged in discreditable conduct while running the Vancouver Police Department. Graham did not face disciplinary action because he retired. Bruce Dean is a street photographer who says he's often harassed by police. He filed the first complaint against the chief, the complaint alleging discreditable conduct. An RCMP chief superintendent agreed.
Chief Jamie Graham committed discreditable conduct.
I beat the WCB, that's who's covering this.
Parents are renting a house off
that. Oh yeah? Oh really? Off now?
Yeah, the fucking chief of police.
Yeah, oh really, yeah. Yeah, he's got a nice seat. I think he just got a brand new one out.
Yeah, totally.
Yeah. And did you hear the history behind that? I knew somebody. My parents were renting two houses.
Man.
Yeah, I know. Are they renting a smaller one up top or something like that?
Oh, yeah, cool.
Yeah, because I found out from another activist who's taking individual classes at U Vic. The prof took him to walk on the beach on top of the Saanich Nation and said, "I'm right here. This house right here is being built on top of the Saanich unceded land, and it's an ancestral village, and they believe burial site." And they said, and the assessment on the land was a bullshit assessment, and everyone's mad about it, but he rushed it through and got approval from the the Saanich Council to go ahead and build, but everyone's mad about it because they figure it's, he used his privilege as like the chief of police to
for his house or for the one on top?
For both of them. And they didn't even know he was building two houses. They thought he said that in his plan he was going to build one similar to the last one as all. And then I was talking to him, I said, no, it's two houses. It's got the main house, and I said, it's got the slave entrance, or the slave house, you know, like that, you know, whatever, the help, whatever, right? And so it's funny that your parents meant that from that. That's so...
$3,000 a month.
Really, $3,000 a month he's making up? Thanks. Yeah, that's pretty bad that he did that. But I use that as an example to show how colonialist he is, because he, I want to take a picture of Wolf's pocket. Hurry, camera. What are you taking your time? Now this is the only time it ever has been slow opening up. Jesus, man, there he's looking. Can I zoom it fast enough? Not fast enough, Bruce. One of these things. Right?
You know Taylor down there?
But my problem is I suck at names all my life.
Oh, but I don't remember what it is.
Yeah,
Taylor started doing side like 2 months ago. I was smoking like close to an eighth a day of weed.
Yeah.
I've crushed the shit since I was
fucking
side.
Yeah,
I gotta sleep too.
I do is my weed. But my cancer, I don't take any chances. But I use my weed to beat my cancer. That's how I beat my my prostate cancer was I just started pumping out Phoenix Tears. I got one of the oldest, probably the oldest now, federal license in Canada for growing marijuana. I've had it for over a quarter century. And so as soon as I found out that I had the prostate cancer and they said it's stage 4, I went home, I amped up my production, I started making Phoenix Tears oil. And then they said there was going to be for sure surgery and radiation therapy, but I had to pick which one was first, and if they didn't work, I was going to have to do the other one and then chemo if they didn't work, eh? And I, all of a sudden, it was just radiation therapy, and he goes, oh, looks like it's working. I said, you guys didn't even think it was going to work. What made the difference? I said, just admit it was my marijuana made the difference. Yeah, that's why I'm totally alive.
True, right? It's fucking with my MS. When I get up in the morning, I feel like I'm pronated, pointing the other way.
Yeah.
As soon as I start to walk, I drag a foot and fall over, right? As soon as I hit the bong, I have some pokes, fucking straight up, stand up straight, fucking back doesn't hurt. I don't want to try.
Oh, it is, man. And so what
I have a license where I took two of them, one for my friends, right? For native implants.
Oh, really, eh?
I prescribed for myself for 26 grams a day.
Mine is 69 plants, my license.
Mine was 121 plants, and my buddy's was 60.
So I just never had enough space to grow, so that was always. Even right now, I can barely do the 69. That's what I do. I'm a clone master. I can just clone like crazy and stuff. I have a really good success rate with cloning, so that's how I just keep my stuff going, eh?
Let's go smoke some pot. Let's go smoke some pot. Let's go smoke some pot. Let's go smoke some pot.
Get some planters down with some soil in them. Can you put some bones in there or something?
Oh yeah, for sure. For sure. And but the easiest.
This gotta be my last day with the site. My plans are not even on.
Yeah?
I'm not gonna go clean my house. I lost like 25 pounds before that.
I lost that from the cancer. That's from, man, the cancer that's just taking all my weight.
Bitch tits are gone. No, I can't imagine about that. I got a six pack and a bag of chips.
I know, man. That's how I am now, too, because of the cancer. It's like people are like, man, you're looking out, eh? I'm just like, no, I'm dying. I'm still happy. It looks good, you know?
Yeah.
Because I had like that, you know, I'm 65 now. I had that.
Are you?
I had that for sure.
See? You're like me. You don't look at 65, though.
Yeah, I think it's the weed, I think. Honestly, I think I've got the natural disposition to look younger. Right on, I wouldn't guess that. I got the natural disposition to look younger, but I also just think it's the weed. You should see all my friends, high school friends next to them. I look like one of their kids, you know? And my hair always pisses them off. They're always like, it's fucking hair. But I think also that it helps with so many things. If I have bad rosacea, and I always need to have monocycline to take it to keep it in control.
Yeah.
Ever since I started doing the high dose Phoenix Tears for my cancers, I don't need it anymore. It just cured but it's basically gone. And if I ever cut down on the Phoenix Tears, it'll start to come back. So it totally controls things like that, skin conditions. Like, it's amazing what it does, eh?
When I was diagnosed with MS, they told me I had primary progressive multiple sclerosis.
Yeah.
So you're likely to become severely disabled. There's no medicine, there's no cure, and you're likely to become severely disabled. And I was like, that's it. And I left and I went to the MS Society, and the first guy I saw was this guy named Bruce.
So there you go.
And Bruce was sitting in his chair. Oh, his name was Carl, actually. He was sitting in his wheelchair and he was blowing a tube to go from this side to that side of the fucking room. And I was like, that's going to be me? I don't know. Time for the doctor, he had it wrong. I've got relapse and remitting. It's all good.
Oh, okay.
I smoked so much weed for so long. I'll get back into that.
Well, and I've heard a lot of good stuff that the potential health-wise for MS and from marijuana, but also other stuff too, from natural treatments that can really help, you know, either offset it, limit it, or slow it down even too. So I think there's a lot of hope, you know.
Can't do that good for MS.
What's that?
Look at speed every day, can't be that good for MS.
No, that's
I just slept for 2 days.
Yeah, I used to do a lot of shit myself too, but now I just slowed down. my whole plan is just to stretch it out as long as I can now, so I'm trying to get as healthy as possible with everything.
Bruce, you look fantastic. I gotta be honest, I wouldn't put 65 on it.
Well, thanks very much, appreciate Yeah. And one of the good things too for me is the cycling, man. It makes such a difference having an e-bike, whatever.
Yeah.
Because then if I'm hurting, I let the bike do the work. And if I'm not hurting, I can still get exercise and keep
so
my range
of motion. So I can get an e-bike?
Oh, you could totally, man.
Okay.
And well, it depends on your balance is. If you have no problem, it's great. But if not, you get yourself a trike. The trikes are wicked, man.
I get a trike.
In fact, the trikes, if you set them up right, but no one in town here knows how to do it right. So there's a company down called Utah Trikes down in Utah. And they know how to set them up right. And then you get yourself one of them, a Lord one, street slick stuff. It's a go-kart.
Yeah.
So you'd be able to have a prescribed go-kart covered by your health plan that you'd be able to rip around in town on stuff there. They're a gas. Oh, yeah, man.
Oh.
What's going on?
Back is sore, man.
Yeah, oh, yeah, they're sitting right there watching this, man. And they're mad at me because I was driving around yesterday with a fucking police flag on the back of the trailer.
Once the police have convinced the white public that the so-called Negro community is a criminal element, they can go in and question, brutalize, murder unarmed, innocent Negroes, and the white public is gullible enough to back them up. This makes the Negro community a police state. This makes the Negro neighborhood a police state. It's the most heavily patrolled. It has more police in it than any other neighborhood, yet it has more crime in it than any other neighborhood. How can you have more cops and more crime? Why? It shows you that the cops must be in cahoots with the criminals.
Bobby, so I'm gonna make this really funny video because I also have videos because I know they train out of there because I filmed them a lot of times coming out of there.
You're hilarious.
At the stop sign and they police cars and the Saanich, pardon me, and the cops are cancer all on the stop sign there. So I got a video of that too, so I'm gonna make a really funny video out of this. I have no issues with cops or cancer. I don't have any issue with them raising funds for cancer. You know, that's a good thing. Although my thing is, why do we have disabled people living in poverty? Why do we have to fundraise?
Why do I get $500 a month for my housing when it costs $1,319?
Exactly. Those are the things. So cops are getting, hey, look at us for being helping. Police are good.
I get $500 a month for housing.
Yeah.
And the housing is $1,300.
I know, it's just insane, man.
And I got a 10-day notice to vacate, about $600 shy of this month's rent, so it's got to come on. Paycheck on that month, right?
Yeah. That's nice.
I'm taking it dry.
Yeah, it's a drag, man.
I got $250 on me. I wonder if they got a drink for me to get some fucking cigarettes. I worked there for 3 years, I should know.
Yeah. Hey man, well, I'm gonna hit the road. Yeah, I'm sorry, bad name. What's your name?
Robert.
Robert?
Yeah, I rolled out Bobby down here because nobody else in my life knows Bobby.
Yeah.
This place I like to roll out.
Hey man, well, nice bumping you. I'm sure we'll see you down here again too. I basically come out and hang out just to look out for these old stuff like that and ride a camera as a witness to them. So.
I got a positive style. Off.
Yeah, they're. I don't know if they're watching us or if they're watching the guys beside them, but they're making everybody nervous. I wonder if they ever do this in the rich neighborhoods. Park us like someone's house and stare.
I never seen them.
Yeah. No.
I've seen people whipping by. There's a naked guy down in Lake Street Village a couple of days ago. Not naked, walking around. Right? And, yeah, an ex-girlfriend of mine said, I'm glad he wasn't aroused. And then fucking he was bleeding a bit, right? And then the fucking cop was wailing down the road, and then she came out and she found him fucking on the ground again.
Yeah.
Bleeding way more.
Were you gonna kick his head in or something? Or?
The cops, man.
Oh, the cops, you think? Oh, yeah. Fuck, man. I wouldn't doubt it for a second.
No, I seen them fucking pull a guy out of the garbage can or the cardboard or something, and then he was going to sleep in my old apartment building and came out of the game. And the fucking cops came up and they were just like, hey, wake up, you gotta come on. And then he wasn't coming out. And they're like, you're okay, and they kicked him around. Finally, they just flipped it over to the side and fucking ripped him out of there and fucking cuffed him, threw him down, threw him around. And I saw a video of that.
Yeah.
I have my camera right there.
That's sweet to do, man. It's always good, man. Film the cops. That's always the thing to do. Hey, man. Well, I'm going to hit the road here. Yeah, you too, man. Have a good one.
Are you guys going
to
race?
Yeah, we're going to have a race here. I'm not getting you too close to my there.
I'll be the flag girl.
Yeah, hey, man. See you later. See you later, Mikey.
Locked up over there.
got that cop tripping on you on my rear camera going in, man. I just checked to make sure it's still my gut at all, man.
I'm gonna fuck the police.
Oh yeah, you're the fourth person now.
Yeah, I put Canada with three K's on it, and I got a police crest on there with a crossed out with a blue line through the police and stuff.
I used to stick my mouth. I used to stick my fucking.
So they just said it just couldn't be on the grass. That's what they were doing.
They like this is a good park. That tow truck was for me.
I know, totally. I overheard him. I said, "Fuck what?" And that's why I told Mikey. That they were here for that. They didn't even give anybody a chance to move it. They just were going to fuck
they ran my plate. They ran my plate and I thought they fucked off. Oh. But they got a thing out for me now.
Oh, really, eh?
They're mad. They tried to get me a couple times. And
oh, yeah. They just tripped on Mikey there. So you're allowed to park it there now or you have to move it again?
It's yellow. It's not yellow curb.
That's what I was wondering.
Hey?
Sorry, I couldn't hear? Oh, so no cigarette. No cigarette.
Oh, I got a cigarette.
Hey Mike, I'm gonna hit the road. I'm gonna make you a fun video out of that shit though. Oh yeah, they were ready to pounce. The only thing that saved it was he brought the wrong fucking tow truck.
Yeah.
And so that's why it bought you time.
Again, because the last tow truck driver was
But they were pouncing and that's what they wanted. The whole thing is they wanted you and your bike.
As soon as they ran my plate, they peeled out of there. Yeah. And I'm like, oh, they left me alone. But they come around.
Well, what's your plate like? As far as did they know it's you, or does it have? You have any warrants related, or is it?
No,
like,
it's
been
out.
Yeah.
No, I've had. My driver. From Kenny Tucker. Had him as a driver, and we were down in Ammo, and we got pulled over. You know, we had a problem today, and then another time, and we drove away. Like you know, we had no problem. We drove away, and another time we went through a shop check or whatever, and. And the truck, known. So anyways, Kenny's parole officer at this next meeting or whatever, he says, no. So he actually had his parole revoked. So here it's like, fuck those guys. You know what I mean? And then, so he got his parole revoked and went in for fucking 2 more years. What a slap in the fucking head that is. Yeah. But I said, fuck it, Kenny. You know what I mean? Are you kidding me right now, man? Right, and I kind of made him, right? But he's an adult. He's saying, "Oh, fuck you, Mikey," or something. Like that. They gave me my weapons back. How many times? Bail violation. Last time they fucking threw me in jail, and then they told me I could have my meth though, which I'm not. It's a bail violation, but it's for next time, right? Yeah. So they can fucking nail me next time. They impounded my bike time before, two days before, for 24 hours.
It's a game
they
play.
They can't take it.
Oh,
okay. They're just fucking with me. They don't like that I'm. They tried to bust me for shit that I'm not doing. And I'm like, I'm not doing it. I told you guys this.
And there's real crimes out there, and they do not shit about it.
Wasting on people that are just
trying to survive. Yeah, and
I'm at a Harley camp. And that's they harassed me based on my exercise in the Constitutional Rights Freedom Association. Yeah. And I asked them about that. I was like, why the fuck? How'd you get away with that? And they're like, well, it depends on the cop. I'm like, but it's a systematic discrimination.
Oh, totally it is, 100%, man. It's undeniable.
My constitution.
And they even they get busted for it every once in a while in the Supreme Court, but they don't give a shit. They keep doing it.
Well, so what the Supreme Court does is they just won't take the case. they don't set precedents. They just let you get away.
But even even for housing around here, they did it. I'm out of here. Why? You need something? What do you say, sir? Oh, okay, yeah, no worries. I'm sitting out of here.
All levels of government.
I had a recent speed breakup.
Oh, okay.
Four patches.
Hey.
Yeah, they all do it. They have like bylaw. They're not following the Constitution, man.
No, not at all. They're some of the worst. Yeah, have a good one.
And now the end is near, and so I face the final curtain. My friend, I'll say it clear, I'll state my case, of which I'm certain. I've lived a life that's full. I've traveled each and every highway and more, much more than this. I did it my way. Regrets, I've had a few, but then again, too few to mention. I did what I had to do, saw it through without exemption. I planned each charted course, each careful step along the byway. More, much more than this, I did it my way. Yes, there were times, I'm sure you knew, when I bit off more than I could chew. But through it all, when there was done,